Well, I got a text from Noah this morning, and he said that the ark had landed and the fish were biting, so might as well come out of my cave and get up here and scratch an itch. So we're gonna see what it's like out here in the post-diluvial period with water stained. It says 83 degrees, 84. Okay, I've been wanting to try this salamander double donkey rig here for quite some time. It has a inline 1/8 ounce salamander sinker, and then it has 2 liters, and I put a sinker chartreuse pumpkin on that one and a dirt colored one on that one. And the idea is if they grab one, you'll kind of leave it down there and let the other ones flail around, and maybe if there's another bass around, it'll grab that. So let's see if we can get some action on this. I know what you're thinking. Those 2 liters are going to get all tangled up, but actually they don't. It's a pretty fun thing to use. Okay. Got one fish on my double donkey. Let's see if I can play him around a little bit and maybe get another one to grab a hold. Woo, baby. That's a good one. Come here, big boy. Okay, that's a very pretty bass. It's lovely. Ooh, he's been eating fish. His tail sticking out of his mouth. Yep. Woo, baby. That's a good one. Have a great day. Yes, sir. You fish are just eating dirt today. And when they grab it, they mean it too. He's pretty good color. Pretty nice fish. Fat. Okay. Bite. Okay, I can see some aquatic vegetation popping up over there. Bang, 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 bang. Come on now. I think I know what that is. Mr. Bluegill. So, Mr. Bluegill, we got a little treat for you. Something I know you'll like. Okay. You're a big Mr. Bluegill, if that's what you are. Oh, my. Yes, sir. Wow, they don't get much prettier than that. This bluegill is 8 inches long. Look at that. Nice fish. Should have brought my basket. This bluegill, you just go crazy. Wow. Okay. Pretty cool little lure. Okay. Ooh. That's a good fish. That's another very, very pretty and healthy bass. Lovely. Okay, this kind of fishing can be characterized as kind of a weightless sensation. Because you really can't feel your bait, it's just out there kind of floating around. That's why I just let it sink and then lift it up. And then all I'm doing is I'm just kind of feeling right here, just kind of feeling here to see, feel if anything goes tap or thump. And when that does, then I'll reel a slack down and try to set the hook on it. But when you do feel something, go ahead and set the hook. Because you probably have a fish on there. So it's probably like fishing on the moon or something. Or your lure is weightless. And in this fish's case, it's weightless. we got a pretty good bass. Yeah, you like to eat dirt, don't you, bub? Fish are tight in here, really strong. They've been swimming in a current. Probably trying to keep their head above water with all the flood. Nice fish. Okay, see ya. And to be accurate, dirt is not a zinker. Dirt color comes in the Stirke King Zero. Okay, there appears to be a congregation of bass down here close to the spillway. I imagine they are having to hang on with their claws and teeth and toenails and everything else to keep them getting washed down into the creek. More BP, more BP. This is for you, David. More BP. Too bad they're not smallies, huh? Let them eat dirt. Eat that dirt. Eat that dirt. That's what that bass was thinking. Twee! Well, thanks for coming along today. My itch definitely got scratched. The numbers of bass today were good. No wowee fish, but there were some decent ones on there. So this concludes our post-diluvial fish festival. We'll do this again real soon.